humpback whale
over by the fishing boat, starboard side. We have a slowdown on the ferry. I'm not seeing it. Everybody else is seeing. Oh, there it is. Yeah. The streaks are the windows in the ferry. There it is again. I don't know if you can see any of this. You need to see the, when he blows the, there he is again. No, oh, there's the tail flute. Who wants to see the humpback whale? Well, that was cool. Saw the blowhole. The spout. And then I saw the flute on that one. I had it zoomed out, so I don't know if I caught it on camera. But I did catch all the people looking, trying to see. Even the locals go over and look when there's a chance at sighting a whale. 3 or 4 days ago, the harvest moon, the full moon, and it's the harvest moon. And so she likes to recognize all these different things, but for an excuse to get together with family. And I love it, because I would never see anybody if I didn't get these kinds of invites. My girl's with. She knows where we're going because we're on the ferry. So she's really excited because we're going to go over there and she's going to browbeat everybody and get walks and ball tosses and everything from everybody who's there. And she knows how to do it, don't you, Dilly? She looks all innocent, but she can work you. Really, she knows how to do it. Alrighty. I'm in an Asian parking in Seattle, and these things are freaking fantastic. A big smile, too.
Baby?
Oh, yeah, she's really happy. She likes coming here.
Yanos is on his way.
What are we looking at in the oven?
The bing that we're having for dinner.
Oh, we're having bing for dinner.
I'm gonna open the door.
Ooh. Oh, those look good. Are they filled?
Yes, with chicken.
Oh, yum.
Chicken stuff. Yeah. There's two flavors. This one is king mushroom chicken, and I don't know what else. The other one has no mushroom, but it has red pepper.
Ooh. So it's a little hot. Oh, that's the sweet
Korean
red pepper.
Red pepper, yeah.
That's the sweet red pepper, yeah.
Is this your glass, Yano?
Sweet red pepper, yes. That's you are being experimenting on.
Rice. That's right, because that's I already had its taste.
Oh.
Because, well, Steve was like, I wonder how hot these are. And I said, well, cut off a chunk and taste it.
All right.
So he said, here, Tim, you try it first. Not quite. Looks good. What time is it?
Well, it's not.
It's an all experimental meal, huh?
Yes. And we've got someone else with an iron stomach.
Yeah. She'll finish off anything that doesn't work. So what are these called again?
Li dou peng.
And it's a moon pie, right? How does that translate?
Green.
Moon cake.
Moon cake.
And yes, then, one type of moon cake.
And then the muffins were round. So the theme was the harvest moon, everything's round, right?
Our theme anyway.
Oh, our theme, okay. It's at this point in this story that I forget that I'm trying to make videos and stop videoing. I just didn't pull out the camera. A rookie mistake. Here I go through this whole process of getting kind of a story together about this wonderful dinner. I mean, it was so simple. It was such a simple meal. But I think that's part of the harvest moon, is that it's the simple things
It was just two meat sandwiches and one vegetable. And I think the idea is to hearken to the simple things in life. I mean, I'm assuming that when this moon comes up, that most harvests are in. I'm not a farmer. I don't know. I imagine it varies all around the world. But if you're in the northern climates, you're probably farming and bringing in your crops. Well, anyhow, we sat at the table. We talked for, I don't know, probably an hour and a half or 2 hours. And then my brother took me back to the ferry. And Dilly and I came home. interesting way to finish a video. But if I want to tell a story, sometimes I just have to tell it. I mean, I try to do it with the images. But there's also the spoken word. Thanks for watching.